Hello everybody, my name is Dr. Yan Yu. As some of you may know, I'm the founder of the Calgary Guide to Understanding Disease, which is a free and open access medical education learning tool designed to help students truly understand the pathophysiology of how diseases manifest. It's a medical education resource that's used by thousands of medical learners worldwide. Because of the popularity of the Calgary Guide, I'd like to further help our learners by making a series of YouTube videos about as many Calgary Guide slides as possible. We have over 800 of them, so there's gonna be a lot. But the goal is to really help you so that whether you're at home or you're on the go, you can open up a video and study at your convenience. So with that, let's move on to the first video, where I'll be talking about just why the Calgary Guide was started and our philosophy and our approach to things. You can help us and support us in our work by liking this video just as it's starting out, and also subscribing to my channel so that you can be kept up to date for when the next video appears. Thanks, and let's get started with the first video. So before we get started on describing what the Calgary Guide is about, I always like to thank the key people involved first and just make sure that they're recognized, because really our project would not have been successful without the great people involved. First and foremost, we have to acknowledge the students who were involved every single year since their founding in 2012. Since then, we've had teams of over 30 to 40 students every year. These are a dedicated group of exceptional volunteers, and props to them for developing this excellent resource. And these students weren't just students from the University of Calgary either, but students from around the world. We also wouldn't be anywhere without our faculty. We are a student-faculty collaboration. And so with our faculty, we not only have myself, I'm not only the founder, but I'm also the faculty coordinator. But importantly, we would not be anywhere without Dr. David Keegan, who is our founding faculty advisor, who helped us shape the mission and the guiding principles of our not-for-profit organization. As well, Mr. Mike Paget and his team of IT department folks, who were instrumental in believing in us right from day one and giving us website hosting services provided by the University of Calgary, and also managing our website so that it functions as smoothly as possible. I'd also like to acknowledge our faculty sponsors, which are the Associate Deans of the University of Calgary Medical School, Dr. Bruce Wright, Dr. Sylvain Coderre, and then Dr. Chris Nogler. We also have over 50 dedicated faculty reviewers who volunteer their time to review our content. And finally, we would also like to thank our international collaborators, our folks in Indonesia, in China, in Germany, and other countries around the world, who volunteer their time to translate our content into different languages. So now that we've acknowledged the people, we really need to talk about why there was a need for the Calgary Guide in the first place. And the need is because in most medical education lectures, you'll see a list almost every 5 minutes, or almost every minute. Here I present the physical exam signs of a myocardial infarction, otherwise known as a heart attack. And you can see that there's a list of signs that the lecturer will usually present to you. The issue is, why does an MI present the way it does? The problem is that these lists are rarely, if ever, explained as well as they could be to the medical student level during a lecture. So what this does to new medical students, given their limited time and their large volume of material that they have to learn, is that if the material is explained well, that leads to successful learning and retention of the information. If it's not explained well, like if the student is just presented with a list, then there's a risk of memorizing instead of truly understanding a topic. And so what results is non-durable learning. So that's where we see the opportunity for us to make a difference in medical education, is to be able to provide concise, very well-worded, logical, step-by-step explanations. Explanations that are worded at the basic medical student level to help improve student understanding. In terms of who we are, the top left photo shows the initial group, and then the right photo shows different students in different years. And then finally, of course, during the COVID era, we have our Zoom meetings. And here's our philosophy. We believe that understanding is better than memorization. We believe that the why behind disease manifestation can be taught simply and coherently. We also believe that quality learning tools should be free of charge to any learner who wants to learn. And so what that boiled down to, after I combed through our medical library, both the online version and our in-person version, is that we really needed a new self-study medical resource, a resource that is student-authored, faculty-reviewed, student-authored to ensure that the content is presented in a simple enough way, and faculty-reviewed, of course, to ensure content accuracy, that the explanations are simple to understand, that they're logical and they're organized in a step-by-step manner so as to not miss a step in the explanatory process, and also that they're free. And our content is licensed by Creative Commons, so you can feel free to use and share our work as long as you cite our entire slide. So this is how we present our information on the physical exam findings of myocardial infarction. Now, I know this is a lot more information than just a list, but think about it this way. We don't try to make our flowcharts into slideshow presentable slides, even though we call them slides. Because what we do instead is we try to make each flowchart into a textbook replacement such that each flowchart takes the place of a couple of pages worth of textbooks, which, in our view, is a fair trade-off for our learners. Here are some basic themes regarding every single slide that you'll see. You'll see, first of all, an organized flow with a pathophysiologic cause and a mechanism that stems from the cause and an effect that stems from the mechanism, so that every single sign or symptom or lab finding is explained by a purple box mechanism. We present our signs or symptoms or complications of disease as clearly displayed end results of the flowchart. We have a color-coded legend so that we can help the learner just understand where they are on the flowchart and what the content of each text box refers to. And finally, this is perhaps one of the trade secrets of the Calgary Guide, is that we have very precise wording. We agonize over the wording that we use in the mechanisms that we use to describe why the signs and symptoms are the way they are. We also, of course, have transparent attribution so that every author and reviewer and every faculty author and reviewer of the slide is credited fully. Finally, our content is free. Now, since August of 2012, our content has been used in over 180 countries, serving almost 1 million unique users, with 8.5 million total visits and over 3,000 daily visits. And we now have developed over 800 unique flowcharts, one corresponding to each medical topic. We not only made flowcharts, but we've also been reviewing their benefit on medical learners, namely medical students at the University of Calgary. In one recent survey, we found that the Calgary Guide is a valuable learning tool to the great majority of students. We also, based on our Google Analytics data, saw that during COVID-19 especially, the Calgary Guide was used way more frequently, and many people described it as a time-saving and very useful way of learning. You can see that users per 14 days more than doubled from the same period in 2019 versus the same period in 2020. And these peaks actually corresponded to social media shares of our resource, which we didn't pay for and we didn't market at all. None of the widespread use of Calgary Guide so far has been that way because of any marketing on our part. This is just a series of photos and screenshots showing the social media that's been promoting our work. And cheers to these social media influencers for helping us share our work with others. And you can find QR codes to our Twitter feed, to our Instagram, and to our Facebook page so that you can better connect with us. In terms of anecdotal feedback, we've received feedback from not just medical students locally here in Calgary, but from medical learners in the Philippines, Pakistan, Australia, Indonesia, and Turkey, and a whole bunch of other countries. We're really proud of our work here at the Calgary Guide, and we're really excited to be presenting our work to you in a YouTube video format. I'm going to try to record as many slides as possible so that whether you're studying at home or you're a learner on the go, you can open one of these videos and learn what you need to learn. You can help us and show support for our work by liking this video and also subscribing to my channel so you can be kept up to date for future YouTube videos.